الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله إمام المرسلين وخاتم النبيين وصفوة من الخلق أجمعين سيدي سادات العرب والعجم فخر ربيع ومضر فيا أيها الراجون شفاعته أكثر من الصلاة عليه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم سليما كثيرا امتدت عين بنظر وعت أذن بخبر وقطرت السماء بمطر وتنفس كل حاقد وانقهر ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one we ask help, mercy, forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bad deeds of ourselves and the evil of our souls. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided will never be misguided. But whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave to be stray, abandoned, leave them in charge of their own self, they will never be guided. They are in a serious trouble. I bear witness there is no Lord or deity worthy to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one and only one. And Muhammad, peace be upon him, his servant, his messenger, the best and purest of Allah's creation, the face of glad tidings, the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As to follow, my dear brothers, dear sisters, respected elders, the best greeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you and upon all the bright faces that came to prostrate, make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one and only one, deserving of your sujood, deserving of your prostration, and to all the sincere hearts that finds comfort, happiness, satisfaction, content, trust, success with هذا العظيم, success with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who declared, لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم, بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, قل, say to them, do not count your Islam upon me as a favor. Allah bestowed his favor upon you that guided you to the iman, guided you to the faith. The big question right now and the reality we have to analyze today and to scan, how did we receive Islam? How did Islam reach us? The big question and this reality that most likely we are unaware of. How did Islam reach us? Islam reached us through the Sahaba, through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Tabi'een, with the Rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved Al-Quran, Al-Dhikr, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Dhikra, we think that only the Qur'an is protected, only the Qur'an is preserved. It's actually the Qur'an and the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is protected. It's in the Qur'an. Al-Dhikr, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, Al-Dhikr in the Qur'an, it means the Qur'an. Al-Dhikra, it means the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ahadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did Islam reach us? Did it reach us through the Sahaba making salah once a week? No. Did it reach us through the Sahaba donating once a year the leftover of their money? No. Did it reach us by the Sahaba making salah only in Eid time or in Ramadan time or funeral time? No. Islam reached us the precious way. Islam reached us through sacrifices. Islam reached us through struggle and suffering and hardship. Take a look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the engineer of happiness, Muhammad, and the champion of success. He was offered all type of wealth. He was offered all type of high status so they could strip and rip the iman out of his heart. He refused. He said, Wallahi ya ammi, law wada'u ash-shamsa biyamini wal-qamara bishamali ala an atruka hadha ad-din ma tarakta hatta yudhhirahu Allah aw ahlaka duna. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without blinking an eye, without thinking twice or blinking an eye, he immediately turned down this offer of high status, this offer of wealth, so Islam would reach us. He said, Wallahi, my uncle, I make an oath by Allah, if they put the sun on my right and the moon in my left, so I would let go and quit this deen, I will never do that until Allah makes this deen prevail or I will vanish without it. My dear brothers and sisters, how did Islam reach us? Did Islam reach us the easy, cool, comfortable way, where nowadays we have it the easy way, where we have all Islam in one CD? Islam reached us the hardship way. Islam reached us through struggle and sacrifices, through suffering. Take a look at Rasulullah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who's Muhammad? The best of Allah's creation, the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best the sun shine upon, khayr man tala'at alayhi shams, making sujood by the Kaaba. What happened? The kuffar, they bring the leftover and the stomach, dirty stomach of a dhabiha, of a slaughtered animal, and put it on top of the head, the honorable head of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while he was making sujood. Anyone of us experienced that? I believe none of us. Islam reached us through the hard way, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to be ejected. He unwillingly left the best place that Allah loves, Mecca al-Mukarramah. The best place that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves, Mecca al-Mukarramah. He was ejected unwillingly. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in At-Ta'if. Take just a little bit of observation, how did Islam reach us? The hard way, the difficult way. Islam reached us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inviting the people of At-Ta'if ila hayya ala as-salah, hayya ala al-falah, qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say to the kuffar, to the non-believers, say la ilaha illallah, you will achieve success. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inviting them to success, to the honorable world, life of Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inviting them to the happy life of Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received that goodness that he offered them. They sent back the answer by stoning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by making Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bleeding. The people of At-Ta'if, he is inviting them to success, to Al-Falah. And they answer that invitation by returning back fire, by stoning Rasulullah, stoning the best of Allah's creation. He leaned on a mountain and he said, Allahumma inni ashku ilayka dha'fa quwwati wa qillati hilati wa hawani 'ala an-nas. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب المستضعفين يا ربي اللهم إلى من تكلني إلى بعيد يتجهمني أم إلى عدو ملكته أمري إن لم يكن بك علي غضب فلا أبالي. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saddened, bleeding, he called Allah and complained that he is so weak, and asking Allah's forgiveness and mercy, asking Allah, Ya Allah, if you are not angry with me, I don't care, I don't mind. Islam reached us the hard way, the struggle way. Islam reached us the precious way, through sacrifices. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a great risk, hiding with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu in the cave, Bil-Kahf. Death is so close to them, more than your ear closer to your nose. And what happened? Allah wants this message to prevail. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Uhud, wounded, facing death, real risk. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam badly wounded in Uhud. What happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants this deen to reach us. Take a look at the Sahaba. Take a look at Bilal. The Bilal, the Muaddin, the one who used to call people to As-Salah, Hayya ala As-Salah, Hayya ala Al-Falah. What happened to him? Look, did this happen to you? Did it happen to your dad or grandfather? What happened to Bilal alayhi salam? He was tortured so badly. They want to rip and strip the Iman and Islam out of his heart. Islam did not reach us the easy way. All what he said and kept repeating, Ahadun Ahad. See, they could control the body. They are in charge of his body, but they can't reach the heart. The heart is clinging into La ilaha illallah. As Sahaba, they were wondering. They were really amazed how Bilal alayhi salam handled the torture. They asked him, how did you handle the torture? كيف تحملت العذاب? He answered عليه السلام, كانت هناك حلاوة الإيمان ومرارة العذاب. حلاوة الإيمان ومرارة العذاب. فطغت حلاوة الإيمان على مرارة العذاب فعذبت العذاب. الله أكبر. Bilal عليه السلام, he said, when they asked him, wondering, surprised, how did he handle that major torture, severe torture? They want to rip and strip his heart out of Islam, out of La ilaha illallah. They are not in charge of his heart. He said, it used to be the bitterness and the pain of the torture and the beauty and delicious taste of the Iman, the faith. The bitterness and the pain of the torture, the beauty and delicious taste of the Iman. He said the beauty and the delicious taste of the Iman overwhelmed the taste of the torture. فَعَذِبْتُ الْعَذَابِ. As if someone drinking a delicious cup of milk. My dear brothers and sisters, how did Islam reach us? Did Islam reach us the easy way? Did Islam reach us the comfortable way? Did the Sahaba donated once a year $500, thinking about it 500 times before they donate for an Islamic cause? Not at all. Take a look at Ala Yasir. Ala Yasir, they were tortured. The mother gored, stabbed in the stomach, just to let go of La ilaha illallah, so this way Islam would not reach us. All of them vanished. The whole family of Ala Yasir, they vanished before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, the best of Allah's creation, looking at them and telling them, Sabran Ala Yasir, fa inna maw'idukum al-jannah. Patience Ala Yasir. They were tortured. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could not do anything. Told them, Sabran Ala Yasir. Patience Ala Yasir. Your appointments, the Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters, how did Islam reach us? When you think about this reality, you will see that Islam is so precious. Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, this giant, Amir al-Mu'mineen, risking his life, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go to the Medina, risking his life, knowing that he could face a surety and he could face a real death. Islam reached us the difficult way. Islam reached us by the Sahaba being so generous, like Uthman bin Affan, radiyallahu anhu. What did he do? He supplied a whole army. He prepared a whole army with all what they need. Islam reached us the precious way by Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu, donating half of his wealth fi sabilillah. Islam reached us the precious way by Abu Dahdah radiyallahu anhu, hearing one ayah. The Sahaba, they used to listen and learn 10 ayat, they pause, they put it in practice, and then they move on to the other ayat. Abu Dahdah heard one ayah, man dhal ladhi yuqridu Allah qardan hasana fayudha'ifhu lahu adha'afan kathira. When he heard that one ayah, he came. He knew there is an Islamic matter, and that's what really matters. He knew there is an invitation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knew that there is an opportunity for business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always successful. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, face to face, asking him, أَيُّ رِيدُ اللَّهُ مِنَّ الْقَرْضِ? Does Allah wants alone from us? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Na'am. Immediately, he shook the honorable hand, the best hand the sun shined upon. He shook the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Aqrattu Rabbi ha'iti. He donated the best garden and the biggest garden he has, and that garden used to have 600 palm trees. At the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometimes the honorable Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tie his stomach, doesn't have one piece of date. And here Abu Dahdah, for Islam and for this precious deen and for this precious da'wah, he donated instantly as soon he heard that one ayah. Who's going to loan Allah a good loan? And Allah replied right away that Allah would compensate you many folds. Immediately, he donated the best garden with more than 600 palm trees. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so happy, so thrilled, and said, كَمْ مِنْ عِثْقٍ رَدَّاحٍ لِأَبِ الدَّحْدَاحِ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. How many heavy tree with fruits in the Jannah for Abi Dahdah? My dear brothers and sisters, when we see this deen, when we see this precious Islam, we think that it reached us through the internet, or by default my parents were Muslim, or by da'wah, or by dua, somebody made dua for me. But in reality, Islam reached us the hard way, through sacrifices, struggle, suffering, and hardship. That's why we have Islam the easy way. My dear brothers and sisters, when you look at this precious pearl called Islam, the most precious pearl on earth called Islam, the happy life of Islam, the dignified life of Islam, the pure life of Islam, the healing in Islam, the true mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us by guiding us to Islam and guiding us to the Iman. لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not count your favor. Do not count your favor upon me that you are a Muslim. Allah bestowed His favors upon you that He guided you to the Iman, guided you to the faith. لولا الله لما اهتدينا ولا صمنا ولا صلينا. It's a fact. If it wasn't of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will not be guided, we will not fast, we will not establish salah. My dear brothers and sisters, when you look at this precious pearl called Islam, this precious pearl did not just come by itself to the surface. A diver dive deep in the ocean and risk his life, risk everything he has to give us this precious pearl. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with the Sahaba, with the Tabi'een, they risked their life, they sacrificed, they suffered, they struggled, they made jihad, and much more to give us Islam the easy way. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم وأستغفره إنه نور السماوات والأرض الغفور الرحيم استغفر الله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين وجزا الله محمدا عنا بما هو أهله. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, peace and blessing be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward our Prophet, his family, his companions to the best of what they deserve on our behalf, on behalf of the past and future Muslim generation. Allahumma ameen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his family and companions, they sweat blood. They sweat very hard. They struggled to give us Islam the easy, cool, comfortable way. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam reached us through the hardship of Al-Mukhlisin, through the hardship of the sincere people, such as Al-Bukhari, radiyallahu anhu. Al-Bukhari used to travel and struggle to get one hadith. Right now we have one CD with all the ahadith. Are we putting this in practice? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Al-Bukhari, may Allah be pleased with him, sometimes traveling miles and miles, and if he has a doubt in a hadith, he will come back without the hadith. Just to show you that Islam reached us the precious way. Islam reached us the most precious way. And how are we going to transfer this message? How are we going to pass this message to our generation and their generation? We are busy with this life. Some people, the most of their concern is this dunya. That's what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said. من كانت الدنيا أكبر همّة جعل الله فقره بين عيني. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us and warning us that those, that the dunya, this life, is the most of their concern, the most of their worries. That means they struggle only for this dunya. Allah will put their poverties right before their face. Means wherever they go, they are facing poverties. How are we going? The question here, how did Islam reach us? And how are we going to make Islam reach our generation and reach their generation and stay with it? Stay with this generation, engraved in their heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Here we think that if you are busy with the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are behind with this life. Where we shortchange our deen, busy only with this dunya, and giving the leftover of our time to this deen, giving the leftover of our wealth to this deen, while uqsimu billah, one of the greatest blessing upon us, and the most great blessing upon us, it is Islam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to the faith. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to Islam. If it wasn't for Allah, we will charge others a membership, a very expensive membership to enter Islam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pays you when you happen to be that person, that Islam will reach this person by your effort and by your hand. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Means those who struggle, those who strived in our cause, Allah saying, Allah promising, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Allah would guide you to the path. And the tafsir to the path means to the happy life, this life and in the hereafter. So if you are busy passing the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are busy passing this deen to others, if you are busy with the words of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, you are considered in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a struggling person, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to give you a good life by saying, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا, will guide them to the path. In the tafsir it says, means happiness in this life, happiness in the life after. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala furthermore declared, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا. See, once you are busy and your concern is this deen, once the most of your concern, this deen, and your worries is this deen, take a look what Allah says about you. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promising. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never delay the delivery. Take a look at this promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you happen to be among those who are busy serving this deen and doing good deeds, it's a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must live this promise in this life, in the hereafter. Man amila, those who are doing good deeds, ذكرٌ أو أنثى, male or female, and they have faith, Allah assuring right away, فَاِتَّعْقِيبُ فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Right away, we shall give them a good life. My dear brothers and sisters, they say that Islam is the fastest growing religion on earth. It's a reality, confirmed by Muslim and not yet Muslim, confirmed by the believers and the non-believers, that Islam is the fastest growing religion on earth. It keeps going and growing, mashallah. Why? Why? With all this propaganda against Islam, with this all hate energy and negative energy against Islam, how could it survive and thrive? How could Islam and the light of Islam keeps going? Why? If all people on earth, if everyone on this earth, including animals, tried to blow at the light of the sun, they could never turn the light of the sun. What about the light of Allah? No one can turn the light of Allah, and that is Islam. Islam keeps spreading. Islam keeps going and growing for two reasons. One, it is the truth. Two, we have the proof. Islam is equipped with the truth. Islam is equipped with the truth and produces all the time the proof. Islam also about a belief. Islam is about two things, belief and action. It is not just looking like a Muslim, like the tree called Shajaratu Safla. This tree, you look at it, you will be amazed with it. I mean, to look like a Muslim, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. But the real matter, to deal like a Muslim. The real matter, to act like a Muslim. The real issue, to behave like a Muslim. And that's what's called Shajaratu Safla, the tree called As-Safla. Once you look at it, you'll be amazed with it. You will love it. Once you eat from it, it will kill you. We can't be like Shajaratu Safla. We have to have these two ingredients, belief and action. Islam is about belief and action. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You will want to reach this status? We want to go back to this status where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are the best of all for mankind. You enjoin in what's good, you forbid what's bad, and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, Islam is about action. Right now, we heard a bit of what happened before we got Islam. How did we receive Islam? How did Islam reach us? We heard a bit of that. But my dear brothers and sisters, the real reality, how are we going to pass Islam to our generation? How are we going to pass Islam to their generation and get that great honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to live happy life in here, in this life and in the hereafter? Think about it. The answer, it is not verbal. The answer needs to be produced by action. And remember, whenever we see ourselves in comfort and prosperity, others struggled, others suffered and sacrificed the best of what they have. So me and you can get Islam the easy way, the comfortable way. So this way we preserve the message of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on our hearts and pass it on. رب مستمع خير من متكلم. A listener much better than a speaker. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت. اللهم ارحم المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم الأموات. اللهم انصر الإسلام في كل مكان. اللهم قاتل ودمر أعداء الإسلام في كل مكان. اللهم سألك الميتة الحسنة. اللهم سألك الفردوس الأعلى من غير سابق عذاب. يا الله, you are the most kind, most merciful. يا رب العالمين, you love forgiveness. اللهم grant us your forgiveness. اللهم grant our children هداية. اللهم heal our ill ones and loved ones. اللهم unite us with our loved ones in paradise without any previous punishment. اللهم grant us the happy and honorable life of لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and the honorable death of لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم. قوموا لصلاتكم ارحمكم الله.